everyone, and welcome to this month education piece. And what I'm willing to show you this month is some wrapping techniques, maybe some techniques which will be really simple and you can start with that. I will show you some technique which you can flow from one wrap to another one. You can transition really easy. I will show you some techniques where even if the baby is still awake, you can still take those beautiful shots. Or if the baby is super slumber, then maybe you've done some shots where it's nudie, maybe you can add a little bit of a wrap to change it up a little bit, to add some bows and to add some elements which will change the entire setup and the entire gallery variation, to say it like that. What I do today is that I'm having my baby doll, and if anyone wants to know, you go to Kmart and you buy a $15 baby doll and you practice on it. I have this one and I have another one filled with rice, which is falls a little bit more heavier in the props, but for today's video I will use this one. Then you need some cheesecloth wraps, super extra long, just to add some textures in there. Some knitted wraps are very good also, and I love them. This one is another wrap cut from a piece of backdrop, bean backdrop. So I always cut a piece wider, between 30 to 40 centimeters wide, and usually they are about 1.2, 1.5 long. Some small ones, if you want something different, again, cut from a backdrop. You see this one is a little bit shorter on the width side, but again, depends on your baby how wide it is. Then I have a base wrap, and this base wrap, it's a four-way stretch, and that's what you have to use, especially when you want to have something stretchy to hold that baby in place. I do have some nude, usually I use nude nappy covers or white, depending on the first wrap, how you start with. And then I have just a simple knitted, super cute wrap layers. You can use this in bowls, but also you can use it as wrap. Cool. And the last thing what you'll need also are some rubber bands. I like to use this one, the rubber ones, to make my flower wrap, and sometimes I use my hair bands around the legs, and I will show you how I do that. So, without waiting, let's get started. And what I will do, I will start with my, if I find it, I will put the baby into the nappy cover. Cool, let's get started. When I start, I always want to think about my workflow. And I'm thinking, usually, what's my last wrap and how I can utilize that as a last setup. So that's why I put the nappy cover over the nappy, especially when I do wrapped shots. And if I have this nappy cover, then I can put it even on the beanbag, and I can shot the baby on a beanbag with this nappy cover if I want, or I use a white wrap over the top on a beanbag. So that will be the first thing. Because I have long legs, I'm always able to wrap my babies on my lap. So the first wrap what I would like to show you is the wrap where if the baby is not super sleepy and he tries to fight, then usually I do this wrap where I push his hands inside. So, and I always also use this wrap if I want to put it in bowls, but the bowl is round and I want to curl the baby in the bowl. And what you have to do that time is to make sure that the hands are down. What I do, you have two options, or to start with the hands underneath the chin or to leave them down. And usually I do both depending on what do I want to use. But let's say the baby is still awake and you just want the hands inside. So you put the wrap on your legs about 25% from the wrap, and then you put the baby's hand over the tummy, take this wrap and push it over the tummy opposite side. With the opposite, you come over the chest, one more time over the chest and underneath the back, and you come on the side of the shoulder. So pretty much you just go around like a burrito. Now you put his legs, the baby's leg, over the tummy, and then from the shoulder you come underneath the bum and you go round. So we go round. So that's your first wrap. Cool. If you want to do what you can do with this, you can put it over the baby's head and you have that baby bouncing look. Okay, your baby's legs will be much nicer than mine, something like that. So that's a baby bouncing. Because you have the hands inside, you're able to curl your baby like you want to make that C shape. If you had the hands in here, it's a little bit harder because the hands are in the way and you can't do that. That's why if I start with a potato, I start with the hands here. But if my baby is not super sleepy and just awake, then I start with the hands down. And because he's such in a great cocoon, he will fall asleep over time. And then I can unwrap this wrap. So let's say you've done this shot, you put it in the posy or in a bowl, and then you say, oh, the baby fall asleep, let me do something else. So this wrap, you just easily take it around. Let's say you go underneath the baby slowly, and then your baby will be into your nappy cover, again depending of the color what you have. And then what you can use, you can take this super easy wrap, just a simple layer, and you can put it underneath the baby with gentle moves. If you want and you're clever, you could have had this layer in the bowl just as a layer cover. That means in the moment when you took the baby's round and about wrap, pretty much what you had under the bowl, under the baby in the bowl, was a mess of this wrap. Then what you can do, you can just unfold it like that, put the baby's hands over the chin, and then come with this wrap over the baby and just make bows. Now, you can make the bows as knots, which I believe, in my opinion, it's harder. Or what I do, you can make the bows using the rubber bands. It's easier and easier to open this wrap. So you've done a bow wrap like so, and you still have those hands on the chest. Then you do another one. You do as many as you want. Use as many rubber bands you want. Okay, I don't have any requirements or how many bows you can do. So you utilize that wrap, that layer from underneath, to make another wrapping technique. Then what do I do with the legs? Well, because we use this bow wrap, so usually you can do the praying position. And this is where you can use another bow wrap, and rubber band. I use the hair ones, and I hold the babies
like in praying position. And then I come with my last one, and you can go around if you want, or whatever it's easier for you. And this is where I make a knot, very tight knot over the baby, like so. Now, keep in mind, my baby doesn't have flexibility of staying like that. So you can put pillows underneath his legs, and also once that the baby has his legs over the tummy, he will stay in this position. So you make another bow wrap in here. You can use a rubber band to make that bow wrap. So you've done that, and now you have the praying position with the legs, with the feet. You have two bow ties, and the baby can stay like that, or you can push it in some another prop, maybe something a little bit longer, like a trench ball. It's up to you. But keep in mind, we went from a fully wrapped or round, round and about wrap, how I call it, to utilizing a layer from underneath the baby. So pretty much you got 6-7 shots in a matter of seconds, just taking one wrap down and utilizing the layer from underneath. Beautiful. So once that you've done this, then you can take the baby, because he will be asleep by this time, and you can move it into a beanbag. Now I will show you one more technique which I love to use, and again it's a little bit much simpler than the previous one, and it will be a little bit easier to take the wrap out with the baby's hands inside. So this time we put the baby's hands over the tummy, and again we come with the wrap over the baby's chest, and you hold those hands in place with one of your hands. And this time pretty much I go on the back of the baby's, and I use the other one coming on the side. Make sure that a wrap is super stretched, and make sure that it looks like wings. All right, so the baby chest is secure, then the hand legs are over the baby's tummy, and what you do now, you come from the shoulder down and hold those legs, and you go on the other side, and then again from the other side you come underneath the baby, underneath the bum, and you come in the baby's neck, behind the neck, and that's where you can do a knot. And this is where you can leave the wrap underneath the baby, like so. Or what you can do, it covers the baby's legs, bring a fluff or anything, a pillow, which you can fill the gap in between the legs and the, let's see, this wrap, for example, because it's smaller. You can fill that gap. And then you can use another wrap to create another type of wrapping technique. That means, if we continue with this, let's say you put a little bit of fluff in that gap to make it round, and we will use the crisscross technique now. So you start from the side of the hip, baby's hip. Then you go on the opposite shoulder. Then you come on the shoulder on the other side. Then you go down over the baby's tummy, underneath the hip, opposite hip. And then you go on the other, underneath the bum, opposite side, and you go opposite shoulder. It's kind of like an infinity sign, yeah. And what I do usually, I go a little bit lower with, every time I go with one layer, I go two fingers lower. And because if you think like that, the first layer is closer to the ear, then I go to the next two fingers down. And what do you do with the last piece? Well, you can leave it on the back, or I bring it a little bit underneath there, underneath the last layer.
So this one, it's a crisscross, I call it, or you can name it the infinity wrap, because you go around and around and around. That's where you can use this cheesecloth wrap that you give different textures and layers. Now, if you had this one and the hands are inside, that means you can't do potato. So for potato, I'll show you the next technique. And it's super easy. It's the same. But again, we will put a little bit of a spin around each layer so you can get a little bit more variety into your gallery. So again, this one, if you, the first layer, if you open it, pretty much it's super easy to open, because you didn't have so many layers over the baby's hands. Remember, he wasn't made like a burrito. This time it was kind of a, like a jacket restraint over the front. You go in the back and they come down. Good. So for potato shot, we will do three different poses, variation of wrapping and techniques. So we start with 25% from my wrap. Usually that's how I do my potato. The hands are coming underneath the baby's chin, and the 25% I'm going of the wrap, I'm going over the baby's arms, and I push it underneath the baby as much as you can, so you don't allow those hands to come out. You make, want to make it tight. Something like two fingers, you can push it underneath the wrap. Don't make it too tight so you don't cut the baby's circulation. When you think about potato, you want to make sure that you don't have heat in the room, because you'll have three layers of wraps. So you want to make sure that the baby is happy. And again, if you see signs of baby going purple or of anything like that, finish that pose, because you're starting to cut the circulation of the baby. So keep an eye on that. Then I put the baby's hands underneath the chin in such a way that the head doesn't flop forward. It's pushed up, and I leave the airways clear so he can hiccup, he can breathe properly. Cool, so we went once like that, and I go one more time over the baby's hands, because I want to make sure that this baby doesn't move. And we put the baby's hand over the tummy, and we go underneath him and over the shoulder. Now, because I'm doing a potato shot, I know I need to fill this gap. So instead of going round, 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 as long as you have your wrap, I'm going with my wrap over the top of the baby. So I keep those little legs in place and they don't move. Perfect. So the hands are under the chin. Now, this is my secret. Keep it in the group. I use a piece of fluff. Or you can use a piece of smaller mohair wrap, something which is really soft. And I fill the gap in between the hands and the legs. And I put it around the baby. Now, if you go on the market and on the shops, some people use belts around here. Some people use, it's like a sack. But I like to use this one because I can just take it off, throw it away, well, put it on the side, and I can go
and utilize this wrap. And I'm not the advocate for any baby costumes or skin wear or something like that. I don't remember how they are called, where the baby is restrained, is because it's so hard to take it off and I can't make different variation of the pose. Cool, so fluff or a mohair wrap to fill that gap. Fill that gap, baby. Then you have the super stretchy knitted wrap, and now we will do a flower wrap. We will do bows. I love bows. So again, halfway my wrap, and I put it over the baby. Again, keep in mind, you can do this with the hands out, with the hands in. And I put it over the baby, and I come on the side, on the other side of his shoulders, baby shoulder. Looks like wings. If you put it like that, you'll have baby's wings. And here you go. You can do another pose. If you put it like that, with wings, depending what you have around, you can say, hey, I've just done baby wings. Try it, you never know. So you cover the baby's front, and now you take your rubber bands, and I lost one, but I found it. So the rubber bands are better than the hair ones because they are slimmer. Then you come with your wrap down and you make little bows, like so. Beautiful. Then, because I don't have more of those, I will use my little ones, my hair ones. And you do another one. You can do hundreds of them if you want. It's up to you. Make sure that it's a nude color so you can fix it in Photoshop if you see the color. And then what you do with the remaining wrap, you go overlapping and you go around the baby's bum and back, like so. Let's fix that. So you got another pose with bows. You can do three if you want. You can do them on the side. It's up to you. Beautiful. And this one you can tie it in the back if you want, or you can put it underneath the baby. Nobody really knows what's underneath there. Awesome. So you've done another pose and you're ready for a shot. And then the last one, and again, if you use a cheesecloth, you can do the cheesecloth, or you can use a stretchy knitted wrap. And maybe what I will do, I will do two wraps techniques, one with that, one with that. So when you have the bows underneath, you have to use something super thick or not see-through. That's the idea. And if you see that you can see the bows, then take a little bit of your fluff, cut it off, and put it over the top of that bow. Or you can cut pieces of your fluff and color it in nude color or any color, gray, nude, white. And you just put it on top of the flowers so it doesn't bump into the wrap, doesn't bleed, I can say, into the next wrap. So with the next one, let's do two layers wrap. Cool. So we start with one wrap on the side of the baby from the right side, let's say, of the bump, and you go around the back. Beautiful. Now you can go down, but what I want to do is to have two layers of different color wraps. So with this one, you put it over the baby and you squish it over the side of the shoulder. and you push it under the baby, and you go down underneath the bum, opposite side of the baby. Cool. Beautiful. And then you make sure that you come up opposite shoulder. And you go around there. Beautiful. Then you had two wraps on the side. So that's not a problem, because now we go down with the other one. And you go shoulder, hip, hip, opposite hip, and up again. And you go underneath and you leave it there. And now you go with the other wrap. And you go shoulder, hip, hip, opposite, wrap. And then you have a crisscross on different layers of wraps. I think it looks good. Different texture, different looks. All right, and what I will do, I will explain you how you take the poses with this wrap. So the first time what you do, you start with the potato in your floccati with this wrap. You take your shots, different angles. You can put it in the back in the floccati. It's up to you. Then you take the baby out. You unwrap the first layer. And then you got the flower, the bow wrap. If you wanted to do a flower, you make a flower the same way, but you make a big flower in front. And again, what you can do is to put maybe behind the baby a different color texture, or you can color change your floccati to match your wrap from underneath, or you prepare a ball, or you prepare a bucket. It's up to you. Then you've done the shot on this one, you take it off. So I believe it's much easier to use rubber bands, in my opinion. Take it off. You take your round layer or fluff layer, and now you have the option to unpeel, I say, the last wrap, and to pose the baby like so. What you can do also is that you can push those little hands underneath, and now you can curl the baby as you want. Once that you've done this pose, you take this off, and then you have your baby nude. And you can move it slowly to another pose in a bowl or on a beanbag. And that's it. You've seen that with a few wraps, you can do quite a bit of work and you can have quite a bit of variation in your gallery. What you want to make sure always is that, one, the baby is fed and happy when you start. So if he cries a lot, try to make him settle down. If he cries a lot, that means it's not fed, he's overtired, or something is wrong. If he fights the wrapping, then it's different, because some babies, they don't like to be wrapped tight. And some parents will tell you, oh, he doesn't like to be wrapped. And you'll be like, it's okay, I got your back. And they will fall into sleep usually. Also, when you think about wrapping, and like you've seen, I used little hair bands,
make sure that they are not very tight and they don't restrain the baby's blood circulation. If you're afraid to use these ones, which for me they are very elastic, but if you're afraid, then just make knots and bows around the baby's legs. You can do that too. When you use potato wrap techniques, because you have three layers and the fluff, in my case, I have no heating around the room. I make sure that the room is okay as temperature, and I move very fast and I don't keep the baby too long in those three layers. That's why I start with three layers and I take one down and I take one down and I take one down. And in this way, I move in my studio with three different color wraps and three different techniques, and I can have variation. Last case scenario, if nothing works, just put the baby in parents' arms and take shots with the parents. Even just simple wrap, like I show you with the hands down, and put the baby to interact with the parents, because sometimes those genuine moments are more important than the entire wrapping technique and the entire struggle. So yes, that was me. I hope you enjoyed this session. I can't wait to see you next time. Please, please, please tell Natalie what would you like to see in the education site. What would you like to for us to do for you and how we can help you? And I'm pretty sure from all the educators, someone will jump in with the correct answer and will help you to get where you want faster, easier, and with happy moments in the way. Have a great day. See you next time. Kisses to all of you.